Good morning, dear students. I am Vipul Kumar, and today is Thursday. As you know, today our math class is there. At the last class, already we completed the chapter fraction and all questions. I hope you understood all things and whatever matter are there. Okay. If you are having any type of doubt, then now you can also ask. Okay. So now we are going to begin our chapter third, rational number. Already I taught you something about the rational number. There are some things. Just see on the board, rational numbers or chapter third. So first topic is natural number. What is the natural number, Ashwin? The natural number means the number start from 1 is called natural numbers. It means the number start from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, it like this at the rate of infinity are called natural numbers. And the natural number is represented by n. Okay, the second definition, whole numbers. And the number start from 0. The numbers start from 0. It means if we add 0 in this natural number, then the natural number called whole number. So the number start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this, infinity, up to infinity, is called whole number. And the whole number is represented by W. Okay. And next thing is integer. What is the integer? Anyone can say what is the integer? So integer means the collection of whole numbers together with negative of counting number called integer. It means integer means the collection of whole number. All whole numbers are there in integer, but with whole numbers some negative numbers are also there. If counting negative numbers together with counting negative numbers is called integer. Okay, it means integer means the whole all types of whole number and with negative counting number both together called integers. Okay, so we will represent integer by q. We will represent integer by q, and the integer is negative 4, negative number also there, negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Not only 4, negative 5, negative 6, 8 here also. Okay, so our next definition is rational number. Okay, take the screenshot and write in a notebook. So now our next definition is rational number. And what is the rational number? Anyone can say? Okay, I will explain. Rational number, the number we can write in the form of P by Q, where Q is not equal to 0. This condition is too much important. And the numbers we can write in the form of P by Q. P by Q means in the form of numerator and denominator, where the denominator Q is not equal to 0 are called the rational numbers. Okay, so the number we can write in the form of P by Q is called rational number. There are two types of rational number, negative rational number and positive rational number. So just see the example 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 9 by 2, these three are the positive rational number, and negative 4 by 3, negative 7 by 8, both are negative rational number. So I think you understand what is the rational number. The rational number means the number we can write in the form of P by Q is called rational number, but Q is not equal to 0. This is the most important condition. Okay, so this is the example of rational numbers. Okay, next four important things are there, so you just learn and write in a notebook. This thing too much important. Just see, every natural number is a rational number. It means every natural number is a rational number. हर कोई natural number क्या होता है? Rational number होता है, compulsory है. Okay. Next, every whole number is a rational number. Same thing also. Every whole number is also a rational number. कोई भी whole number भी एक rational number होता है. It is also compulsory. Means two both compulsory conditions are there. Next, every integer is also a rational number. Every integer, चाहे negative हो चाहे positive, are called a rational number. Every integer is also called a rational number. Next, every fraction is also a rational number. Every type of fraction is also a rational number. So these four things is too much important for the exam. One mark question is there, two false or like this. So just see once again, every natural number is a rational number, every whole number is a rational number, every integer is also a rational number, and every fraction is also a rational number. Okay, just take the screenshot and write in a notebook. Okay, students, So the theory of the chapter 3rd rational number is already completed. So now we are going to begin our exercise 3.1. Okay. So first question is true and false. Just state the statement. Afterwards say that what is true and what is false. The first statement: every natural number is a rational number. Means every natural number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is a rational number. So already we are I wrote that there are four conditions. In that one condition is there. Every natural number is a rational number. So this condition is true. हर कोई नेचुरल नंबर क्या होता है जो रेशनल नंबर होता है ये कंपलसरी है. ओके नेक्स्ट जीरो इज द स्मॉलेस्ट रेशनल नंबर. सो आई टोल्ड यू दैट रेशनल नंबर मींस दैट देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ रेशनल नंबर नेगेटिव रेशनल नंबर एंड पॉजिटिव रेशनल नंबर. सो द नेगेटिव रेशनल नंबर इज लेस देन जीरो. सो जीरो इज नॉट स्मॉलेस्ट रेशनल नंबर. ओके सो देयर आर मेनी स्मॉलेस्ट रेशनल नंबर आर देयर. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज फॉल्स. जीरो इज नॉट अ स्मॉलेस्ट रेशनल नंबर बट जीरो इज स्मॉलेस्ट होल नंबर. ओके and then next condition, some rational numbers are not whole numbers. Yes, it is true. This condition is true. Some rational numbers are there that is not whole number. Suppose 1 by 2, negative 4 by 7, negative 5 by 7. This is rational numbers but not a whole numbers. Okay, next condition, there is no rational number which is not a fraction. ऐसा कोई भी rational number नहीं है जो fraction नहीं है. बिल्कुल condition में है क्योंकि yes, all rational numbers are in the form of a fraction. All types of rational numbers are in the form of numerator and denominator. And where is numerator and denominator? We will call it the fraction. So there is no rational number which is not a fraction. Okay. So take the screenshot and write it on notebook. Okay. So question number second. Which of the following are positive rational number? It means in the following numbers you have to identify the positive rational number. So already I told you there is positive symbol is called positive rational number. If there is negative symbol is there then called negative rational number. So just see first negative 7 by 17. It means this is a negative rational number. Okay, but we choose only positive rational number. Okay, positive rational number. That's next negative 27 by negative 36. It means there are two negative symbols are there. So negative and negative is positive. It means this is 27 by 36. Because negative and negative symbol is positive symbol are there. So negative and negative positive. So this is 27 by 36 and this is a positive rational number. This is your first answer. Next, 35 by negative 13. This is also a negative rational number. Okay, next 14 by 27. This is positive rational number and next negative 27. It means there is no denominator, so we can write denominator 1. So this is a negative rational number. Okay. So your answer is negative 27 by negative 36 is a positive rational number and 14 by 27. Only 2 are positive, rest 3A, C and E are negative rational number. Okay. Take the screenshot and write in a notebook. Okay, next question number third, we have to represent the rational number on the number line. Okay, so we will draw the number line and represent the following numbers on it. It means we have to draw the number line and we have to represent the numbers on the given number line. So first we have to draw a number line. Okay, so 0, number line 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4 and negative 5. Okay, so just see the denominator on the given fraction. Afterwards you can easily represent on the number line. Okay, for each question you have to make the separate number line. Okay, so first question, negative 1 by 4, it means denominator is 4. So we will give the divide all numbers by 4. So if we will divide negative 5 by 4, then negative 5 by 4, negative 4 by 4, negative 3 by 4, negative 2 by 4, negative 1 by 4, 0 by 4, 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4, 4 by 4 and 1 by 4. So just see where is your number, negative 1 by 4. So this is your number you represent on the number line. If you want to represent 3 by 4, so draw a separate line, one more separate line, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. negative 1, negative 2, and negative 3. So there is denominator 4, so you just give the divide by 4. 4, 0 by 4, 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4, 4 by 4, and 5 by 4. So the number is 3 by 4, so this is your 3 by 4, you represent on the number line. This is the first one, and this is the second one. Okay, next 5 by 4 and negative 3 by 4, you have to make two separate lines. Afterwards, give the divide by 4, and like this, you represent on the number line. If the denominator is different, then you can give the different number, whatever is given by divide. Afterwards, you represent on the number line. Okay, take the screenshot, and rest 2 is your homework. Make a line and draw in your notebook. Okay. Okay, student. So in exercise 3.1, the question number 4th is also there. So this is the value based question. So no need to solve this type of question. Okay. If it is necessary, then we will, when school will open, then I will solve the all things of this question. Okay. So just leave the 4th question. Okay. When school will start, then I will solve on board. Okay. So now exercise 3.2. Express the following rational number in their simplest form. See, what is the meaning of simplest form? Anyone can say? Palak. What is the meaning of simplest form? The simplest form is, it means if the given rational number, numerator and denominator both are divisible by a same number, then we have to give the divide by the same number and change in the simplest form. Okay, simplest form means if the given rational numbers, there are two terms, numerator and denominator, both numbers, numerator and denominator, are if divisible by same number, then we can give the divide and change in the form. That form is called simplest form. Okay, so this 3 and 33, 3 is also divisible by 3 and 33 is also divisible by 3. So we will give by 3 divided by 3 and 33 also by 3. Then 3 1 3, negative 1. 3, 11, 33. So this is your simplest form. Just see, the important thing is both numerator and denominator divisible by same number, then only we have to give the divide. Okay, otherwise just that is your simplest form. Okay, negative 40 and negative 25, sorry, 40 and negative 25. 40 divisible by 2, but 25 is not divisible by 2. Okay, so both are divisible by 5, so 40 is divided by 5 and 25 is also divided by 5. So 40 divided by 5, then 8, and 25 divided by 5, negative 5. Okay, so this is your simplest form. Okay, Pratha, any doubt? Next, negative 17 by 56. Both number is not divisible by any number, so this is your simplest form. Already this is your simplest form. Okay, and next 51 by 26. Here also both number is not divisible by same number, so this is also your simplest form. Okay, Isika, any doubt? So simplest form means if the given rational number, there are two terms, numerator and denominator, if both are divisible by same number, then we have to make the divide and change in the form of, that form is called simplest form. So okay, so this is your answer. Take the screenshot and write in your notebook. Okay, so this is your last question. Next, we have to solve in the next class. Okay, so the second question, find two rational numbers equivalent to each of the following numbers. Okay, so you are given some number, so you have to find out the two rational number equivalent of the given number. Okay, so there are many questions. I solve only two, rest all for your homework. Just try to solve. If you have any type of doubt, then you can ask. Okay, so I will solve. Just see carefully. First one, 27 by 48, and the second one, negative 2 by 1, and we have to find out the two equivalent rational number of the given number. So first we will write 27 by 48. So our, when, if we have to find out the rational number of the equivalent rational number of the given number, so we have to multiply by both 2 by 2. So 27 multiplied by 2 means 54, and 48 multiplied by 2 means 96. This is our first equivalent rational number of 27 by 48. And the second, if you have to find out the second, then 27 by 48, afterwards we will multiply by 3 by 3, then 27 3 ja 81 and 48 3 ja 144. Okay, so this is our second equivalent rational number. Now, Mr. if we have to find, the question is asking about only 2. If the question is saying that 3 or 4, if you found out, if you want to find out the next, then for 27 by 48 multiply by 4 by 4, this is also equal to this. If you found out the fourth one next, 27 by 48 multiply by 5 by 5, like this we have to find out. Whatever, how many we have to find out, then we can find out like this. Okay, so this is your rational number, sorry, equivalent rational number of the given following rational number. Like this also, see, negative 2 by 1. So for first equivalent rational number, negative 2 by 1 multiply by 2 by 2, so negative 4 by 2. For the second rational number, negative 2 by 1 multiply by 3 by 3, so negative 6 by 3. For the third rational number, negative 2 by 1 multiply by 4 by 4, so negative 8 by 4. For the fourth rational number, negative 2 by 1 multiply by 5 by 5, so negative 10 by 5. Okay, so now we are, this is a way to find out the rational number, the equivalent rational number of the given rational number. So there are many questions, I solve only 2. So just rest all of your homework, just try to solve. I think you understood all of things today, whatever I taught. Okay, so just try to solve. If you don't understand anything, then you can ask and see the video one or two times. Okay, thank you. Next, the remaining questions we have to make solve in the next class. Okay, thank you.